It is happening. What we have been speculating about for quite some time now on this channel is materializing more and more. Namely that we might see a new Cold War-like situation on the moon. Last week, on March 9th, the Russian space agency Roscosmos signed a memorandum of understanding with the Chinese National Space Agency with the intent of building a moon base together.
But so wants the West under US leadership with the Artemis program. So then, are moon wars inevitable? The West versus the East on the moon? Well, let's try to find out.
In the TV series For All Mankind, a fascinating scenario is depicted in which the moon race didn't end with the last Apollo mission 17 in 1972. But it never stopped, growing more and more and leading to ever more incredible feats of engineering. In fact, the premise of the show is very realistic. If Sergei Korolev wouldn't have died because of a heart condition during surgery in 1966, if he would have continued to live, it is quite possible that the Soviets would have managed to land on the moon at around the same time the US did in 1969 with Apollo 11. In our timeline, however, the N1 rocket, the powerful Soviet super heavy lift rocket that would have landed cosmonaut Alexei Leonov on the moon, exploded all four times that it had launched. We have to say though that by the fourth launch in late 1972, the rocket was actually performing better. Yes, the N1 still exploded, but this time it managed to fly for 110 seconds before it went boom. So the Soviets would have gotten there. Unfortunately, by that time, the US had already landed 6 times on the moon, from Apollo 11 to Apollo 17. Had Sergei Korolev not died, it's quite possible that the N1 would have worked in time to compete with the US in the moon race.
Korolev was an extremely intelligent and capable engineer. Under his supervision, the N1 might have worked in time, but with him gone, his successor Vasily Mishin took over, who was not as capable as him. Had Korolev lived, we might have seen an escalating moon race. The two superpowers would have tried to outdo each other with more insane feats, the way they had been doing in the late 50s and early 60s in our timeline. It is quite likely that both the US and the Soviets would have built moon bases by the 70s in that alternative timeline. This is nicely shown in the TV series For All Mankind. Yes, okay, it's an American TV series, so of course it employs all the really annoying Hollywood cliches of over-dramatizing, overacting, annoying characters and so on, but despite this, it's still worth a watch in our opinion. So anyways, the US and the Russians would have had moon bases by the 70s, and with a continued Cold War, we would have maybe even seen a kind of a Cold War scenario on the moon. Maybe even moon wars, with both sides fighting each other, as is of course also shown in the mentioned TV series. But luckily we can all sleep nicely, because this is all just a TV show or a parallel reality, and luckily in our reality, we didn't get a Cold War on the moon. Moon wars have been averted due to the failure of the Soviets. Or have they? Before we answer that question, please subscribe to our channel, because as you can see, we don't only make Starship videos, but also speculative videos on alternate history. And we explore many other non-standard topics. So thank you very much in advance.
So, fast forward to the year 2021. In our timeline, the moon race ended in 1972. And instead of continued ever greater achievements in space, the US began a long and brutal decline of space capability. Instead of having a moon base, the US retreated back to low Earth orbit, where it stayed content for many decades, until at some point this once mighty superpower wasn't even capable of reaching low Earth orbit anymore, because they had to retire the space shuttle in 2011 without any successor, since Venture Star was shut down at about the point of being finished. Well, there are plenty of examples in history where empires declined, and with them, technological capability. We just have to look at the Great Bronze Age collapse around 1200 BC, or to the collapse of the Western Roman Empire in the late 5th century. Technology collapsed with these empires, and it would take a very long time to get back to the technological level which had been attained before the collapse. Luckily, the US hasn't collapsed yet, although sometimes we have the impression that they are trying their very best to achieve a collapse as soon as possible. Now, joking aside, only recently has the US regained their capability to send astronauts to low Earth orbit, thanks to a company which you might have heard about, SpaceX. And only recently has the US really started to pursue once again the idea of not only revisiting the moon, but building a permanent human settlement on the moon with the Artemis program. Basically, an updated version of the Apollo program, if you will. Okay, but since the Soviet Union doesn't exist anymore, we luckily don't have to be worried about standoff-like situations on the moon between rivaling superpowers anymore, right?
Well, unfortunately, it looks more and more as if instead of the Soviets, we'll have China and the Russians. We all know that Putin is quite sad that the Soviet Union doesn't exist anymore, and Russia just doesn't have the vast resources anymore which the Soviets had 50 years ago. So what do? Of course, they are partnering with China. The leader of the Russian space agency, Dmitry Rogozin, has often said that the Artemis program is far too US-centric, and that Russia would distance itself more and more from the US and instead cooperate with China on space matters. And until recently, this was all not very concrete, but since last week on Tuesday, the 9th of March, it has become much more concrete. On this day, an agreement was signed by Zhang Keqian, director of China National Space Administration, and Dmitry Rogozin, the chief of Russia's space corporation Roscosmos. This agreement foresees the building of a joint scientific lunar base by China and Russia. Basically, China are now the new Soviets. China has a very capable space program, and they have achieved quite some incredible feats in the last 20 years. Only in 2003, they sent the first astronaut, or rather taikonaut, as a Chinese astronaut is called, to low Earth orbit with the Shenzhou 5 spacecraft. In 2016, they launched their first small space station, Tiangong 2, which circled the Earth for 3 years. No, it didn't burn up together with Sandra Bullock, guys. Turns out that was just a movie. Regarding the moon, in 2013 they landed their first probe, Chang'e 3, on the moon, which employed a small moon rover called U2. In early 2019, they landed the probe Chang'e 4 on the far side of the moon, the first ever landing of a probe on the far side of the moon. This probe also contained a small rover U2-2, which is still in operation to this day. In February, they even reached Mars with a space probe, a first for China. A probe which also contains a Mars lander, by the way, complete with a rover. So you see, China is developing very fast in the space arena, and they have been very open about their ambitions to land their taikonauts on the moon by around 2030. They are actually right now already developing the necessary hardware.
They have their deep space capsule already developed. They are developing a heavy lift rocket, which looks like Falcon Heavy, and one super heavy lift rocket, the Long March 9. So this is not some funny fantasy stuff. This is really happening right now. The Chinese are already developing the hardware as we speak. Since Russia under Putin is feeling alienated by the West, siding with China makes more sense for Russia and for the Russian space program from their perspective. So then, by 2030, taikonauts will land on the moon. And China stated that very soon afterwards, they will start building a moon base near the lunar South Pole, a location which makes a lot of sense, since there you have eternal sunshine and also large water ice deposits in the deep craters, such as Shackleton Crater. And guess who else wants to build a moon base near the lunar South Pole? That's right, the US and their allies, Japan, Canada, and the Europeans. So there we go again, the West and the East, both having moon bases near Shackleton Crater by 2030 or later. Given the current funding of NASA and the long history of delays, it's very possible that NASA will not be able to build a moon base which deserves the name base before 2030. We dare to say that one pressurized habitat module might now deserve the name Moonbase, which NASA might actually already achieve by the late 2020s. But given the current budget situation, we think that a moon landing will not happen before 2025 or 2026 with the Artemis 3 mission. Of course, we could argue that the big unknown here is SpaceX. We don't really know the impact of the Starship program on this moon landing timeline. And this, of course, also highly depends on which human landing system NASA will choose to continue to fund later this year. SpaceX's lunar Starship, Dynetics Apaka lander, or the national team's Lobby lander. NASA's decision will have a giant impact. But even if the US can build a moon base before China and Russia, at some point, we will have two rivaling blocks on the moon with their own moon bases. So then, moon wars after all. Astronauts with machine guns like in the trailer to the second season of For All Mankind?
Well, we know as little as you on that matter, but our suspicion is that at most, we'll find a standoffish kind of situation on the moon. We don't think that there will be active combat on the moon, since the two moon bases will likely be too small and non-military in nature. But decades later, by 2050 or 2100, who knows? It is very likely that at some point there will be military installations on the moon. The US Space Force has shown great interest in Starship, which could be used to carry large amounts of troops to the moon. And the Russians and Chinese will surely develop their own version of a Starship-like troop transporter. It's only a matter of time, in our opinion, until the Chinese will copy SpaceX's Starship in some form. And then we will have soldiers from the West and soldiers from the East on the moon. How exactly the situation on the moon will develop, we cannot know. This will very much depend on how the geopolitical situation with the US, Europe, Russia, and China will develop. Will there be a new Cold War? Will there at some point be moderation again between the two blocs? A lot will depend on how the situation on Earth will develop. But moon wars? Even though nobody likes this idea, it cannot be completely ruled out that at some point in the future, we might have some form of moon wars. But we hope not, of course. We hope that humanity will continue evolving not only technologically, but also mentally. And as always, we'd like to thank all the people who help us on our Discord server with the channel here. These are Zabol Chiare, Michael Root, Jay King, Stefan van der Feest,
Another Space Nut, Frederick, Miko, Rich LB,
the guy who always changes his name, MLLT, Warhawk, Lucky Green, and Centauri Sparrow.
You guys are great, and your help is much appreciated. Then thanks for watching the JI Space Report. And I would say, on to the future.